Hey guys, it's ViewMasters Reactions, and we're back with Season 7, Episode 10 of My Little Pony. Last we saw, we got Honest Apple, and it was Applejack being selected to be a judge for a fashion show based on her honesty. I said during the episode, I don't think that's a good way to base things on. I mean, honesty is a great thing, but you probably should pick someone who's somewhat qualified for judging fashion. She even said in the episode, I respect what you do and I see the appreciation you put into it, but I don't really care about fashion. So, I mean, you probably should get somebody that's honest and cares somewhat about fashion, unless you're like, nope, we want a complete outsider opinion, but it's like, what good is it? That's like, Jay, what is the thing you dislike most? All right, we're gonna make you vote on it. It's like, you might get my honest opinion, but who cares if you're getting the honest opinion of someone who could care less about that? To me, it doesn't seem like it would work out quite like it did. And then Applejack went way over the top, destroyed some girl's thing. That was the one line I think she crossed. But beyond that, she was pretty honest. And we met new characters. We met, I think her name was Lily Lace, Starstreak, and Inky Rose. So, I don't know. We met them. We saw a photo finish and Hoity Toity again. So, I'm just going to jump in. There really isn't any direction we're going. We're just doing a lot of story building. And I'm curious to see if we're going to see old friends again. We seem to be seeing a lot of old friends this season. Or at least I feel like it. Unless it was just in the last episode. I mean, we had Macintosh episode. You guys want to be way ahead, full unedited episodes of this and other shows I do, seasons ahead, probably done in full with this entire series, Patreon link at the end, seasons ahead on other shows and dozens of exclusives you'll only see on Patreon, all full unedited, check it out. If not, here we go, Season 7, Episode 10 of My Little Pony.
And that has never called me before.
I'm sure that's not why she looks like that. Maybe the royal sisters aren't seeing eye to eye on something.
Luna and Celestia would never fight.
Never!
So the map sent you to solve a friendship problem?
No. Everything's perfect as
Wait.
Usual, sister.
Luna's pissed about something. We got some sister siblings, blah, 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 blah. Alright, so Luna is not happy with something. I think Luna feels unappreciated. No friggin' way. What?
Is that you?
A royal problem.
I'll show you later. Anyway, enough about me.
We've never seen this before. She shrunk herself and just...
The problem might be between Celestia and Luna.
Is she actually sure? No, my guess is she somehow, like, teleported herself.
This is big! Like, really big!
I need to know the dynamics of how that works. She looks not good.
Too tired. She is like this every morning.
Poor Celestia. That's so sweet that she makes her sister pancakes every morning.
I think what it is that Luna feels like all I do is bring up the moon. Why else would she be depressed?
She's. You do this every night?
She's got a Florida Lee looking cutie mark. Oh, have we seen her? I feel like maybe we've seen them.
They're just getting colder and more distant.
This reminds me of like a Jack and the Beanstalk.
I'm not much help, am I?
No. As you both know, the map sent me here. What is it?
You two.
Excuse me.
Beg your pardon?
Oh, without realizing it. Does it bother you that Luna never notices the wonderful breakfast that you prepare for her? Princess Luna.
Look at her face.
Tell Celestia how you feel about the fact that she never acknowledges the work you put in.
I'm sorry. I never noticed that you make fruit faces on pancakes. Oh, I apologize for not noticing flowers in a wall sconce. Even so, I still make an effort to smile.
Okay, I feel like we should step back.
Don't presume to know what it is like to govern the Dream Realm!
Enough!
What the hell just happened? Oh, she switched them!
Beat each other!
What?
What have you done?
My apologies, Your Majesties. This spell lasts 24 hours. I'm gonna stop talking now.
Look at this. That's the best part.
He's gonna think I'm nuts! Not the only one.
I assure you, I am more than capable of handling all of Celestia's duties.
She's gonna see that everybody bothers Celestia.
Store openings, judging the Royal Rose contest,
she's gotta do all this,
you know, that sort of thing.
Annoying stuff. I'd rather lift refrigerators, throw them on trucks, and do ribbon cutting. So Celestia is pretty awesome then, because she doesn't let it bother. We've seen that guy before, right? The pitcher guy?
It says here that because of me, the school didn't raise enough funds to go on their field trip.
You need to put on a brave face and help these ponies.
Great news! There are no Timberwolves!
No, there are definitely Timberwolves!
Still on for go.
Oh, absolutely.
Look at those guys.
We made it to the end of the day.
I don't know about you, but I feel very well rested.
But see, Luna doesn't sleep through all of Celestia's duties. You could probably do everything easy if you slept all day.
Of course.
Oh god, is it like... Is it?
I can.
This is big! Like, really big!
I was supposed to bring you two closer together, but I've only driven you apart!
I know it's a dream right now, so...
I know how to handle Nightmare Moon.
But can you handle...
me? What the hell is that?
If Luna can turn into Nightmare Moon, turn into me,
Daybreaker.
You don't need Luna. Even when we were apart, I knew I needed her. You don't need any pony.
Yeah, let's dream fighting.
I should have destroyed you!
Without balance, there's no harmony!
What impact does this have right now? They can't die in their dreams, can they?
We get it, you're sad. You could really use some
sun!
Celestia saved her. Put her in a bubble. Like, I forget how strong the dreams are.
That smile's too wide.
Oh my god, that's terrifying. So this is Luna's dream. Here we are.
Why don't you want us to go on our field trip?
I don't...
Oh my god.
It's
that's pretty horrifying. Freaking Children of the Corninger.
I've seen a lot, but I haven't seen this before.
She's afraid this is what would happen if we continue to fight. I'm never going with my gut again.
I thought if we worked together, I have your magic, remember?
I was wrong. Your job is so incredibly hard. It takes such a brave, strong pony.
So it's not just like the job, it's like...
And that pony is you.
The maniacal laugh is great.
In order to defeat Daybreaker, you need only to trust in your strength.
You can't destroy me! I'm everything you want to be! You are not real, and you will never exist again!
I can't imagine they'd introduce a character like that and not use her.
Did you talk to yourself?
A little.
Is this still a dream?
Everyone's dead, Starlight Glimmer. You failed.
I made you some pancakes.
They look weird.
They are terrible.
I know.
I love you, sister.
I love you, too. And this just happened now and not in my dream?
The map was wise to send you, Starlight.
That's a nice way of saying I came dangerously close to messing everything up.
And you have gotten your cutie marks back.
I'm not doing this.
That one means your mission is complete.
I'm so proud of you! Tell me everything!
Twilight, to controlling.
Oh, Timberwolf issue you need to address.
The Timberwolf issue you need to address. I like that. All right, guys, I really did enjoy that episode, but I have a few questions. I feel like now they're just for convenience allowing the ponies to do magic that I've never seen before. In this episode, we had two major events. We had Twilight put herself into the ballerina of a music box. It did have the same gem that Twilight Sparkle uses, the element of harmony, in the music box. But I don't know if that was just to signify it or if that was there because it needed to be there for the magic spell to work or what. But somehow, she teleports herself and she could talk to Starlight Glimmer through this music box. And it's Twilight's consciousness from what it looks like. It looks like she is fully aware of what's going on. But I don't know how that happened. Secondly, other thing, Starlight Glimmer was able to use a magic power that switched their cutie marks. Is that a thing? Have we talked about it? Or did I miss something where she could just do whatever she wants? I know some of these people, like Starlight Glimmer, have ridiculous abilities and stuff, but I don't recall her switching cutie marks. Did that happen? I'm sort of kind of remembering something that happened like that now. But if it did, it only happened like once, and it wasn't enough for me to remember fully. So I'm like, whoa, not for nothing. It wasn't even like she just did it to like random ponies. She did it to two of the most supreme alicorns in all of My Little Pony. She switched their cutie marks. That is some pretty insane capabilities. And I know we've said that Starlight Glimmer is on the upper echelon, I guess, of pony abilities, having strong pony powers, magic user, stuff like that. But that was like, I don't know, if you could switch the cutie marks of Princess Celestia and Luna, like if you go bad again, you have some strong abilities. Other thing I thought that was weird, since the beginning, I always thought Luna's mark was just the moon. I thought she had a different colored flank. I thought her flank was just a different tone or a different color. She had some sort of like mark, like a pony with spots or something like that. But no, her entire mark shifts and it's like clouds with the moon. I mean, that's pretty cool, but it makes more sense now. And I thought that for seven seasons. So we basically have the sisters not appreciating what the others do. And Starlight Glimmer has a heart attack about it because she's thinking I could cause Luna to turn back into Midnight Moon. Midnight Moon? Nightmare Moon. I was going to say, it doesn't sound right. Nightmare Moon. But then we also see Celestia's dark versions called Daybreaker. Pretty awesome. Very powerful. Seemed way more powerful than Nightmare Moon. But our Celestia in her dream at least defeated it. But like, hey, that doesn't mean much to me. It could just be that Starlight Glimmer's dream allowed our Celestia to beat her because we're on the dream. At the end, they all realize, hey, it's not as good as I thought it was on your side and blah, 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 blah. Here's my thing. Luna was following Celestia around all morning and then Luna had to do the lavender. So Luna was with Celestia all day. Celestia slept all day when Luna took over her responsibility and then realized, oh my God, this is a nightmare. But I feel like Celestia always gets away with something or like doesn't really do as much as Luna does. And I think Luna does do more and probably isn't as appreciated as much. But what Celestia should do is jump into the nightmares with her. If you're so upset that she's alone and has nothing to do, jump in the nightmares with her and you could adventure along. We just saw it's capable. They're capable of doing it. We just saw that they were able to do so. So jump in each other's dream world or whatever it is and control dreams together, help each other out, do it like a tag team, and you won't be all freaked out and alone at night. Like Celestia was ready to lose her mind immediately. But I want to jump into another one. You guys want to be way ahead, full unedited reactions to this and other shows I do. Patreon link in front of me. Seasons ahead on other shows and dozens of exclusives, all unedited, full. Check it out. If not, comments down below, like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Peace.